Some directors are known for their style. If their film is shown to an audience of movie watchers, it's more than likely that the audience could name the filmmaker without being told. Iconic directors can be distinguished by a wide range of characteristics in their film, from subject matter and shot composition to certain themes and character types, and to common imagery and symbolism within many of their movies. Filmmakers like Quentin Tarantino, Wes Anderson, and Tim Burton are among the list of iconic directors that have a style to their movies that make them instantly recognizable as their work. But one iconic director that American audiences are less familiar with is Wong Kar Wai. This Hong Kong writer, producer, and director is undoubtedly among the list of iconic directors, and the imagery, symbolism, themes, character types, and filmmaking style that he uses allow audiences to instantly distinguish and recognize one of his films. Wong Kar-wai has only directed 10 films, but has received critical acclaim for the majority of them. Despite the short filmography, it's easy to see that each of his films contain similar characteristics to one another, while being unique in their own way. Three such movies are Chungking Express, Fallen Angels, and In the Mood for Love. The amount of material that can be used as evidence of Wong Kar-wai's status as an iconic director is seemingly overwhelming, so to better illustrate, it's helpful to divide the evidence into three categories: themes, style, and imagery. Relationships and loss are present in all of Wong Kar-wai's films, and his characters' search for connections in their lives are a major theme that plays out constantly. The dichotomy between lost love and new love is always a reality in his films. In Chungking Express, cop 223 tries to fill the void left by his ex-girlfriend by connecting to the woman in the wig. Cop 663 valiantly tries to deal with the loss of his girlfriend, making him all but blind to the attraction Faye has for him. In Fallen Angels, the mute character Ho attempts to create connections with outsiders throughout his entire story, only to return to the closest connection he has, that with his father. Only after we see that he realizes this does Ho lose that connection when his father passes. But no Wong Kar-wai film deals more deeply with relationships and loss than In the Mood for Love. Mr. Chow and Mrs. Chan come to learn that their spouses are in a relationship with each other, and their struggle to understand and cope from their loss is a major theme of the film, as well as how each character reacts to their situation. Another theme that is constant in all of Wong Kar-wai's films is the living city. Hong Kong and the people who live there are more than just locations and extras. They are a character themselves. Wong Kar-wai showcases the everyday people, places, and things that make up Hong Kong daily life, and we see this theme injected into every scene of his movies. The use of Western music is another theme that is common in almost all of Wong Kar-wai's films. Representative of the globalization of Hong Kong and the influence of Western culture on a modernizing China, the soundtracks to Wong Kar-wai's movies are always filled with non-Chinese songs from an array of artists. The Mamas and the Papas, the Cranberries, and Nat King Cole are some of the easiest to recognize. Style is another way that Wong Kar-wai can be considered iconic as a director. Wong Kar-wai has used nearly the same production team for all of his films, and by doing so, he has created a family of filmmakers that can work together to bring his ideas to life in the way that he imagines. Because of this, many stylistic qualities are shared between his movies. One of those qualities is the use of time manipulation. Wong Kar-wai implements some form of time manipulation in Chungking Express, Fallen Angels, and In the Mood for Love. Whether it be simple slow motion scenes, characters moving in slow motion while the world around them moves rapidly, or his infamous use of step printing to create a simultaneous slow and fast effect, Wong Kar-wai employs time manipulation as a style to create moments within moments. Wong Kar-wai also uses quick cuts in each of his films. Each time he does, it mirrors the mental state of the characters he's filming, representing their anxiety, apprehension, and the fear of the unknown. Color has been a defining style of the majority of Wong Kar-wai's work, and while much has been said by critics concerning his use of color, it doesn't make it any less important. Wong Kar Wai's films are art pieces in their own right, using color less as a narrative technique and more as an emotional filter to view the film's moments through. Reds, greens, blues, and yellows are everywhere in his films. The use of fluorescent and neon lights give a vibrancy that exemplifies the living, breathing urban environment of Hong Kong. Another style that Wong Kar Wai and his team use repeatedly in his films is voyeurism. In all three of his films, numerous scenes are shot in such a way that we, as audience members, are brought into the film itself as more than just observers, making us participants rather than mere viewers. He achieves this fly-on-a-wall style in a number of different ways. Frames within frames are a common element, and it's nearly impossible to catch every instance of it in one viewing of any of his films. Wong Kar-wai also uses foreground obstruction to make it seem that we are sneaking a peek of the characters, which stylistically connects to the themes within the story. In Chungking Express, Faye's co-workers continuously pry into the personal relationship between her and Cop 663, and using voyeurism, we are right there with the co-workers, participating in the same way. In Fallen Angels, both protagonists are literally criminals, facing the possibility of getting caught at any time. By shooting in a voyeuristic way, we can feel their constant mindset, that of paranoia. But no film uses this style better than In the Mood for Love, where the protagonists are under the constant threat of nosy neighbors and co-workers spreading gossip about their relationship. Another example of style mirroring themes can be seen in the use of tight spaces and shots. Wong Kar-wai fills his movies with scenes set in both cramped rooms and hallways and crowded city streets and markets. By doing so, he lets the physical spaces that his characters exist in match the mindsets of those characters. It also creates tension for us as audience members, but when those characters are given scenes in open spaces, it emulates their vulnerability rather than break that tension. While themes and style both make up what it means to be a Wong Kar-wai film, his use of repeating imagery is a definitive trait as well. Peppered throughout his films are shots of moments, locations, and objects that make appearances in all of his movies. Wong Kar-wai's films are unique in the sense that they aren't about telling a specific story or showing a character's struggle. His films are about creating a feeling, about portraying life in its most realistic fashion. Moments don't happen in our lives in service to a greater storyline, they just happen. They may not make sense, they may not be expected, and they may not have a happy ending. But everything that happens in our lives reminds us of people, places, times, and events from our past. Wong Kar-wai's films are just like this. And by using repeating themes, styles, and imagery, we are shown something totally familiar, even if it's completely different from our own life. After seeing a handful of his films, audience members would no doubt be able to identify one of Wong Kar-wai's movies because of the style, imagery, and themes. And in this way, we can add him to the list of directors that can truly be called iconic.